Applied Dimensional Analysis, Chemistry Applications. With more complicated dimensional analysis problems, we're going to start with a quantity or in other words a given, and then we're going to use a conversion rate or rates to find its result, or in other words, an equivalent. So let's start with example one. How many molecules are in 1 deciliter of water? So to complete this conversion, we need the following conversion rates. We have Avogadro's number, which is 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd molecules per mole. H2O has 1 mole equal to 18.0158 grams. 1 gram of H2O is 1 milliliter of H2O. And 1,000 milliliters is 1 liter, and 10 deciliters is 1 liter. So we're starting with what we're giving. So that would be the 1 deciliter over 1, and it's water, so I'm going to put in my H2O for the water. Okay, now I'm going to just start putting in the conversions that I have. I have deciliters here, so that means I want deciliters here. And when I look for my conversion for that one that has a deciliters, it's right there. So I have 10 deciliters. And it equals 1 liter. Sometimes I find it helpful to cross off the ones that I've used. So deciliters is gone now and leaves me with liters. So looking now at what I have for liters, I have this conversion. So since I have 1 liter on top, I'm going to put 1 liter in the denominator. And my other part of my conversion is the 1,000 milliliters. So liters are gone. Now I have milliliters, and my next conversion that has milliliters is this one here. So since I have milliliters on top, I'm going to put my milliliters down below. And my other part of my conversion is the gram, so I have 1 gram of H2O. Now, it's not necessarily a big deal of whether I put the H2Os in here for this particular one, because we are staying with water. We are not converting to another chemical element. So it's not quite as important. If I am using other chemical elements, then I need to make sure that I write them all down. Okay, so I have grams of water. So I go to my next conversion that has grams, and I want to put my grams in the bottom. I have 18.0158 grams of H2O for 1 mole of H2O. So now I've used that one up, and my grams of H2O are gone. And now I'm left with moles. This per means, in other words, that it equals 1 mole. So now I'm going to put that conversion in. So I have 1 mole is 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd molecules. So I'm now ready to do my conversion, which means at this point I'm just putting it into my calculator. Everything on top is multiplied, and everything that's on the denominator is divided. So I get that we have 3.34. We're going to take this out, 3 decimals. I have 2.6. times 10 to the 23rd. Since I want to take it to three decimals, I'm going to round here. I'm going to get 3.343 times 10 to the 23rd molecules. All right, let's go to our next conversion. I'm going to put it underneath here. It says we're to convert 451.4 grams of PB to grams of PBO. So, if you didn't know, PB is, I believe, lead. So, we're going to start with what we were given, which is the 451.4 grams of the PB. Now, because I do have different types of molecules here, I want to make sure that I'm putting down all of my conversion and not just part of it. Otherwise, it's really easy to get lost. All right, since I'm starting with grams of PB, I want to look for my conversion that has grams of PB, and that would be this one here. So since I have grams on top, I'm going to put the grams on the bottom. So I have 207.2 grams. And on top, I have one mole of PB. So that conversion's used. That took care of the grams of PB. Now I have moles of PB, so now I want to look for my conversion that has that. And that's going to be this one here. Since moles on top, I'm going to put moles on the denominator. And the three moles of the PBO goes up top. So moles of PB are gone. And I've used that conversion. So now I'm left with three moles of PBO. So I want to look for my conversion that has that. And that will be that one there. Since I have moles of PBO on top, I'm going to put moles of PBO in the bottom. And my grams up top. All right. I now have the desired unit, which is grams of PBO. And it's just a matter of doing my calculation, which I'll just put in the calculator. Remember, everything on top is multiplied. Everything in the denominator is divided. So that gives me 758.14. And we're just going to round this one to 2 grams of PBO.